think mum wanted me to learn the guitar when I was a kid. I always wanted to play footy as a kid, but then once I got to like 14, as I say, and discovered the likes of Oasis, even Bob Dylan, Kings of Leon's earlier stuff was emerging around that time, and learnt myself a few chords, discovered I could sing as well at the same time, a little bit back then, and just practiced and practiced in my room, tried to learn nearly every Oasis song under the sun, all the Beatles songs, started playing cover gigs around town just for a bit of extra money, and thought I'll have a go at writing tunes still about things I'd experienced, and at that time I started going to match, and that's where it really started taking off, because all the tunes I was playing at first were just sort of like the Jam, Stone Roses, the Coral, Oasis, Beatles, the sort of music that, you know, the match going culture listen to, if you like. You look at probably the biggest bands in the world to date, with the Beatles, and you think that they were, you know, from your doorstep, just normal lads knocking around the same streets in the same parks, and, you know, getting on the same buses and everything else that me and my mates are doing all our lives. It's amazing. And what I like about the Beatles, they were sort of the first of a kind, weren't they? They really made the music industry what it is today. And obviously, being from Liverpool, I'm very, very proud of that, and I'm passionate about it. And I like to, you know, in my own music, I'd like to try and stand alone. Like, I'm not saying I'm going to be anywhere near as big as the Beatles, because I don't think anyone ever would be ever again. But to walk in the same sort of footsteps, even marginally, you know, it's great to represent the city and just to that genre of music, you know what I mean? It's great to be involved in it. I got a boss reception off the, you know, the locals in Liverpool, getting behind me, singing these songs. They were all singing along with me. I felt like Liam Gallagher sometimes, you know what I mean? And the turn of 2017-18 was like the sort of the birth of Boss Night, if you like, as a worldwide LFC phenomenon, whatever you want to call it, you know what I mean? It started to build and build really nicely, but I think it went to a ridiculous stage where we could then take it around the world. It was after the LA, LA, LA song, so... to America twice with it. I've been to Dubai, I've been to Ukraine, I've been to Ireland, unteen times from tours of Ireland, I've been to Denmark, I've been to Germany, I've been to France, Barcelona, at Madrid, 60,000 people plus. I was in America and I'd done my last gig of the tour in New York. It was like 7 gigs in 7 days and 90 minute sets, and I know the football songs, but it's not like singing, it's like shouting, you know what I mean? It's like chanting, you're leading it. Hundreds, sometimes thousands of people, you know, together, and it's hard work, like, you're running around. I was absolutely knackered and I was ready to go home to bed, and one of the camera lads phoned me and said, come out, we're having a drink. And I said, no, I'm finished, like, I couldn't have tried. And he said, well, what about this, Jürgen's here, and he specifically told me to phone you and get you out. So I said, all right, I'll be there in a minute. And I turned up at the bar, a small Irish bar down the corner from the hotel, really low key, and Jürgen had his cap on backwards, like with a bevy in his hand, and he actually cheered me as I walked in and just, you know, had a little chat with me and just took the time to say to me that he thought what I was doing was brilliant, you know, in terms of bringing all the fans together. And just another good symbol of what music does. It brings, whether it's in football or in a gig, it brings people together, doesn't it, and it reminds you of good times and everything else. It's been a great ride, it has, but, you know, I like to think there's a bit more to me than just Liverpool songs. The great thing about my gigs with Liverpool is they bring so many people together, and I want to do that on a bigger scale, you know what I mean? I don't want it to just be exclusive to Liverpool fans. I think my tunes are good enough to bring people from all areas and backgrounds together, and, you know, have a good time listening to them, and that's what music's all about for me. It's about telling stories of things you've seen, or, you know, things that have happened to you, and it's also about bringing people together and singing a dance, you know what I mean? The Weekend in Paradise, it's about the sort of you know, the hook, line and the chorus, was it a pointless 3-day bender or a weekend in paradise, my friend? And you can probably sort of get at what I'm playing with. It's just about, you know, when you go out, and we've all done it, we've all been on the scene, haven't we, where we've gone out every Friday, Saturday and Sunday, week after week after week after week, and we've had some great times, haven't we? You can't deny it, but at the same time, you probably sat there on a Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday thinking, why, you know what I mean? Why am I doing it? What have I done? You know, is this me forever? You know what I mean? It's just literally the question of both sides. If it works for you, sounds, crack on. If it doesn't, maybe rein it in a little bit, you know what I mean? Without sounding like Ali G, you know what I mean? I try and keep it as real as possible. And just hopefully, I'm sure, I definitely know the people of Liverpool can relate to it, because the people who have heard the songs already have had great receptions. But I know, in fact, it's not even a hope, I know that people around England, hopefully around, you know, other parts of the world, if you look behind the lyrics and see the messages that I'm trying to put across, hopefully with a little funky beat at the same time as well, that they enjoy it and they get down on it and you know, listen to me records and come and see me live. That's all I want. It's been my dream since I was a kid. So if my music's good enough to make that possible, then sound and bring it on. You know what I mean? Have a good night.